So, same old story about the Pilgrim Fathers, same old speaker about the truths that the world will not contemplate, same old villains and double agents in every war, yeah, mass murderers, the Roosevelt family, on the Mayflower, with the people that I'm going to tell you about today, and the first golf course in the world in Donald Trump's global empire of Augusta master race courses. Yeah, it's in Leiden, where the Pilgrim Fathers sailed from, where Michael Ancram's relatives trained to be the Christian killers that are the launch of Love Your Neighbor all over the world. Okay, there is Arnold Palmer. I'll take you back to my local golf course, and I'll now tell the golfers there what has been the big joke. Yeah, because all of the folk that are the Sweeneys, that are friends of my family, they told me that they had 40 deaths and the flag at half mast at the golf course at Kelso, after I came back in the first year from New Zealand. I now totally understand the secrets that they keep. Okay, so here it is. I can't afford to play golf now. Oh, sorry, I don't need to go back there. Ian Fleming's with his... So do you get it? Fleming is the Flemish coast, which is the Dutch coast, which is the flood-prone region where the British royals launder the narcotics all over the world. And you've just seen Ian Fleming with his cigarette holder. And now I'm going to show you Kelso Golf Club. Yeah, we're at, it was only an 9-hole course when I started. It's right next door to the Kelso Racecourse, and the tract of land in the middle behind that hedge is called a loening. It's a right of way for the ordinary citizens, and in some places they would pay a toll to walk along that safe ground. Okay, at Kelso Racecourse it is sometimes a good option for reducing the entry fee. Yeah. Thank you to all of the loyalists, even the Masons like Arnold Palmer, who was pictured in that first image, because he is on the legendary list of global Freemasons that run the world into all wars for profit, only for private individuals. Okay, so do you get it? The golf course that is in Holland is called the Loenen golf course, the Loening golf course, and I imagine that every one of the golf courses that they construct will have a piece of rough and a piece of hedgerow that will become the Loening joke as long as they can afford to pay for the real estate. And with Donald Trump in charge of 3 or 4 courses, including Turnberry, the St Andrews Hotel, not many people know about that, yeah, and his holdings up in the Aberdeenshire area, he is a massive financial mobster, and his companies in Scotland in wind power are called Dunwilco. I have not got time to tell you that story again. I've told you often enough now. Okay, so do you get it? That is the loaning that runs between the race course, yet the New World Order's creations to race the PISO horses there. Yeah. And those are my old employers that are the race horse owners and breeding family that are the Harrises of Butlins, yet own huge tracts of the River Tweed as well. And all of the private land across our world becomes the pistake that is the Loenen golf course in Holland. Yeah, and they've got Reeds for Reedsdale and the fascists and all of the people that are in those elite family bloodlines. And sadly, the Hollands of the French presidency are part of the story, because they provide the lovers for Longshanks' family. And that is the breach of the timeline for the world-owning bloodline that I've been trying so hard to suss out. I think I've done it now, because what they've done is to change it from being the ancestors for a period of Longshanks, yeah, and into the Galloways and the Utrechts of Galloway, and into Ireland, and into Cumbria, for the Comyns and all of those interlocking names that are so famous and were murdered by Robert the Bruce's family. Anyway, let's tell you the golf story first. I don't know whether or not the Flemings from the Flemish coasts know that entirely, but let me just take you to another tab. So there's the sad indictment, and it's bell-shaped. Yeah, Christianity movement out of that port. Yeah, all of it is flood-prone, as you can see. Ishmir, yeah, and the mayors are the jokes about both the Rothschilds being the mayors in Frankfurt and the emirs. Do you get it? I-G, Jazz emirs. Yet the emirs are the Islamic and the Moorish menace. That is the airbase that mean that the gods can no longer sit on the edge of the clouds. And there, sadly, is the golf course that is Loenen. Yeah, it is absolutely sickening when you understand the joke of that being the rough up the middle of the golf course. Yeah, and of course, the instruments for playing golf are the human prick. And when you get it in the hole, that becomes the PISO vagina. Yeah, ever so crude, but that's what Donald loves to laugh at, and that's what he liked to grab in the presidential campaign. Do you get it? Okay, and the Liverpool linkage to the mafias that are the slaving centres of our world. Yeah. That is the slaves for the Christian nations. That is the launch of the Fleming banks. Massive Confederate versus loyalist government-based American war of independence, revolutionary war, and that is where the Fleming banks started to provide the sandbags. Okay, and the names all around here are totally indicative that this is going to go to the master race place, which is the Harlem Globetrotters hub, yeah, on Long Island in New York, and the top five and most historic golf courses in America are all where the Pilgrim Fathers landed, or they are in that place near New York, near the Brooklyn, which is the Innsbruck joke for Jesus and Pope Benedict and Hitler Rothschild. Yet it cannot get more evil. This is the launch of the replacement of the heavenly gods by the individual, and all of the demonization with the emir stories. That takes you into the El Cid film and his friendship with the emirs, yeah, of North Africa. What else is there on there? It's only a snapshot. But there's the Ellesmere port linkage to Liverpool. There is Brooklyn. There is Newcoop, and that's the chicken and egg jokes and all of the denial of Jesus by St. Peter. Yeah, and Utrecht and all the elite families are right next door. Yeah, that is the places where they live in the Reedsdale regions, and that's Utrecht of Cumbria and Cumberland, who went missing on the timelines that we've profiled so many times. Don't know what's happened there. It looks as if I've been stripped of my right to tell you some of the story. Okay, and so that's the Loenen map of Google Images for the first golf course. There's Schiphol Airport, where I used to fly across. Yeah, and what else is there? Let's scan to the south end of the bell. Yeah, every time a bell rings, an angel gets its wings. Okay, there's the legendary cheese place. The Montforts that are my local councillor. Everything is a repeating cover. Yeah, and there's the cats that are the Calpurnius Piso jokes. That is the ancient history, even if the region I'm living in now, I'm living in a region, and I want to tell you the story about that, and I'll tell you the full story about all of the villages around here, and the sectarian connotations of what happened out of Leiden and Plymouth in England, yet that leads to the troubles in Ireland and all over our globe for ages and ages and ages. Okay, that is a man who's called Lord Lyon, and what he does is take away from the Stamina King, who's pictured there, the man who started the war as the head of the Masons, yet the Lord Lyon takes away the capacity of any Scottish clan or clansman. And that is the story of the Douglases, who are related to the Flemings, the Murrays, and all of the vicious families that come from the Flemish coasts. And then become the owners of our land, like the German equivalents. Whip, Windsor now. Okay? Let me tell you briefly the story of Freskin. I found this months ago, but I found it again yesterday, and it summarises why Andy Murray has been revitalised as the propagandist hub for the whole of this story. Yeah? Okay, Freskin, innocent looking name. You can see the beginnings of the Erskine Bridge Rothschild marriages scams, can you? Okay, Duffus Castle, possibly begun by Freskin, that is up in Aberdeen. The main crime scene is in the region at the moment, and the regions that I've been cast from, yeah, because it's in the Lothian Coast region and the Almond Valley region. And the links are not only to Freskin, which is not a commonly used surname now, it is to the Douglases, it is to the Sholto families, it is to the towns of Broxburn, Ingolston. You remember the Ing joke about the pagans being hung under the oak trees? And the pub that I visited last night proclaimed in the tiny little town of Pumperston that the pub that was the Seven Oaks pub had been closed for reputational reasons several years before. Yeah, that's right across the central belt of Scotland, laughing at the sectarian killing of everybody across our world for 2,000 years. And Obama's had the decency to drop out now that he has been revealed as being Suetonius in the Bible, and Suetorius, yeah, the man who reports for the PISO family, like the people Pliny the Elder and all of those other people who turn out in real life to be the assassins for the PISO family who killed Emperor Nero, whose wife was Poppaea, and that is the poppies on every War Memorial Sunday. Okay, it is a huge story, but let me read the links of the Freskin name to the surnames that launched the Gulf Empire all around the fucking world. Yeah? So, Freskin died before 1171. Was he a Flemish nobleman who settled in Scotland during the reign of King David I, becoming the progenitor of the Murray and Sutherland families? That's Lord Levison Gower of Sutherland. That is all of the Duchess of Sutherland who sent the colonists to the colonies for stealing bread, and they came back as the Murdochs. Sorry, they came back as the Murdochs, having been sent away as the Murdochs. Okay, and the Douglas connection is absolutely massive, and the linguistic jokes in that are gonna, I'm gonna keep you waiting for that. I'm just gonna tell the golf story now. Okay, do you get it? This is Ian Fleming's murderous Flemish coast, and the hub for this family there was Verdun. Yeah, the massive conflicts and the massive war dead toll. Okay, so Freskin is said to have come to the lowlands of Scotland from Flanders, that is, the black and red Douglases of the borders, who I'm so fond of, even in the common man sector. The aristos get shielded by the common man, who fight for them in every great conflict. Thence to Murray, and the Douglas family were so much of a threat to the Windsor own throne, yeah, which came out of Germany all the way through. Yeah, that is the George I to George III jokes, and the butchers of Cumberland who did the massacres in the Stuart Revolution. Yeah, this family was more feared than the Stuarts, because they could look after them using that heraldry stuff that the Lord Lion can declare that your clan cannot have. Yeah, a clan membership affiliation and a claim to the throne, because you've got too many aristocratic names in your label. Okay, so from a charter granted to one of his sons by King William the Lion, it can be ascertained that Freskin held from King David the lands of Strathbrook, that is the badger cull joke even today in West Lothian. Yeah, and it is called now, it is called Broxburn. Yeah, do you get it? The Brock is the badger. And that is the launch globally of the yellow taxis out of the Tourne and Taxi, Northern Alpine Italy. Yeah, and that becomes all of the stuff that is the snitching in the taxi by the people that are engaged in conversation on board. And you have to pay for all of that. Yeah, and it's like the confessional at the Catholic Church. It can be ascertained that Freskin held the areas of Strathbrook in West Lothian, as well as Duffus, that's Aberdeen, massive castles, Rose Isles, Inchicle, Machir, and Kintray in Moray. The Machir is the beautiful beaches at the western Highland coast and in the outer islands. Yeah, and that's the Moray Firth. Yeah, where the air bases are being closed, even when we were going there on our holidays, just to make sure that the man who's going to reveal this, yeah, is informed. Yeah, and they've closed several army outlets last week, including the one in Inverness that was Court David or something, Castle David. Okay, the name Freskin is Flemish, and in the words of Geoffrey Barrow, it's virtually certain that Freskin belonged to a large group of Flemish settlers who came to Scotland in the middle decades of the 12th century and were chiefly to be found in West Lothian and the Valley of the Clyde, where the Abbey already is the Cluny Abbey, the joke that PISO invented Jesus and launched him in France. Yeah, like the French kin that we're talking about here. Was one of several Flemings who had lands in Moray, yeah, that's the Andy Moray jokes, and all the way through into Emperor Napoleon, not the emperor that led the revolution, but by then the King of France, once he's become tame. Bestowed upon him, this seems to have been an attempt by the kings of Scotland, and wait for this, to replace the native Gaelic nobility, yeah, that is the Picts like Braveheart, who live in those little wooden huts that they hang the carcasses from at the end of the treasonous, tyrannous rule, who had resisted the rule and prevented them forming a cohesive kingdom, mainly a French, Flemish, Belgian, yeah, and Waterloo kingdom. No changes for hundreds of years. Okay, let's go back to the golf course. Right then, so, golf. Got a huge tab on the Bolfers in Edinburgh, yeah, and there is the Sheep All Heart. And let me see what the other tabs are so I can get this story together. And below that, we may have much more in terms of images for this course. So there is Golf Club Old Course Loenen, right next to not the Riksstall, but the Riksstaweg. Yeah, and all those mirrors and pawns that mean that the gods are on all of this, and they are absolutely shocked by it. That is the Brooklyn joke. That is the Innsbruck River in Austria for the master race. And that is Brooklyn, where the Roosevelts live. Yeah, and they also live in Oyster Bay, which is the Pearl Harbor joke. Okay, and not many people other than Scottish rustics understand the meaning of the word loaning, but now the whole world will understand it, Donald, like your mistresses and your need to put your finger up their piezo fanny. Yeah, and that's in the debate about your presidential capacity to be a world leader. Okay, old golf club, and let's just keep going down. It's the same image, it seems to me. Terror is also in region. Yeah, and on the front pages of papers every day, that is Aleppo and all of the things that are the jokes about Styria in the Alps being Syria. And all of the people that are the kings and queens of Jerusalem are from the Austrian master race. Okay? And there's Liverpool, and there's Ellesmere Port, and there's Chester, where the richest man in the world lives, and the richest man in the world has holdings in the Central Belt and the borders, and they run private schools, and they get funded by the war dead, and that is Lady Jane Grosvenor, sadly. Yeah, her brother died because he runs massive for-profit interests at the British Legion, and that is the follow-up to Butcher Haig, and Butcher Haig is in all the royal lineages, and I found that out last night. The website for that is so big that it will hang my computer and I will not be able to cover more than one topic at a time. Okay, and it takes you right back to the bloodlines that take you into Solomon's Temple. This is the Eton fraud for the Duke of Westminster. There are several Etons in the northwest of England. Yeah, there's the one in Chester. There's another one up in St. Helens, misspelt for obvious reasons. And there is Mary's arse. Yeah, isn't it funny, Donald, that you've been able to do that and that your dad's name is Fred Christ Trumpf? Yeah, and your relatives out of Germany are the Freuds, and they are now in the Chipping Nortenset, prepared to silence anyone like me by using the drugs that are totally toxic, or the lobotomy techniques that I've told you about in several videos in recent days. Okay, there's the real Grosvenor estate way down in Chester, where David Beckham used to live, and he's back in the news because of my exposures on Princess Anne and their Olympic frauds with Nick Clegg, Seb Coe, and the whole lot of the sad bastards are from these elite bloodlines that have been in charge of all the killings across the world. Yeah, when the Olympics were strictly amateur. Right then, so, and there's the Eton Mere. You get it? Yeah, the Emir joke. Yeah, I did not realise it until you see this. Yeah, and the jokes about the beheading of all of the Douglas family. Yeah, and you can imagine what Douglas means without a lead on it. Yeah, and all of it is the glass bit is very prominent, and it's all based on the fact that they are the colour black. Yeah, and I cannot explain that. We'll leave that to the next video. There's Chester. There's the Grosvenor estate. And the spelling of Eton has changed since I made those videos on the race courses, and the people that were the Vesti families that went to the races in the other gender's shoes. Okay, and there's why the Heaton thing is coming into the political correspondence, and my threat of arrest from the Metropolitan Police in London, because I confronted John Lamont and Paul Wheelhouse, both MSPs running to be MSPs again, I think, and they were privy to all of the secrets of the crimes of Rothschild. Yeah, and they never get mentioned at all. Okay, this is the slaving centre. All of the people that run this are Sir Walter Scott's families and the Dukes of Northumberland, who are the Perseus family in the Roman court. Okay, here is Welcome to the Eton Estate and the rural estates and all the little tricks involving Bernie Eccleston that we use to take your mind off everything that you see in the news. Okay, this is the name of the castle on the golf course at Loenen. Yeah, it has now been totally taken off the social media. You can find it if you're prepared to read about it in Dutch. Yeah? Can you see it? I'll read the first sentence. Kronenberg, Oak, Kroyo, Nenberg. You get the oak joke now, hanging and burning, all of the pagans there. Is in Vormelig Castile by Loenen aan de Vecht in the Netherlands province of Utrecht. Yeah, Utrecht of Cumbria. all of the things we've been looking for, and all of it is the time shift that they launch in the form of the Polis with the TARDIS. And that was to cover the time shift between the birth of Jesus and writing about it in Naples. There's Floris the Fifth. He's the owner of this castle, and his children are sent away to be the lovers, but they never get in bed with Longshanks's kids. And there were dozens of them, I think there were about 26. Most of them died under 6 months, because God is totally against this massive murderous army of aristocrats, in uniforms with the Christian cross on the end of their sword. Okay, let me keep going down. That's only the third tab. And he was chased and killed. Kronenburg Castle and part of Loenen area were then at Graafschap Holland Incorporated. This part of Loenen, the Count Kronenburg until 1819. Yeah, it's absolutely, absolutely ruthless. So that is just a few miles away from Waterloo. You get it? Yeah. 5 centuries remained in Holland and then reunited with Utrecht, and that's the Galloways of Utrecht, and all of the links to the west coast of Scotland, many of which are actually Irish links. And the time shift is massive because they have linked it to the children and the bastard children of King Henry, I think it's the second. In 1426 remained at struggle even for the episcopate in Utrecht. That is the PISO elite church that is the most powerful in the world. And thank you to all of my friends there who are the aristocrats in the borders for continuing to speak to me. Yeah, and realizing that the good man has a way with the gods, and that they are prepared to rise up and begin to contest all of this again. In fight A, battle took place, killing at least 17 people. Yeah, they don't tell you much. Okay, so let's go to the next tab. This is just the history of Utrecht. Yeah, and that's just above the German border, and that's all the places that were ceded by the Beatrix woman and the husband, who became, he was an out and out Nazi, Bernhard. He became a full member of the Allied armies, and he was in charge of the reparations all around the Gulf Coast region that we're talking about, with the Emir pawns for sectarian division. And then they become the Austro-Hungarian valleys. Yeah, all wars, all sides, entirely for profit. And they've got the British-American Batman tobacco joke. Yeah, so all of them who are profiteering from the killings of all of their armies are able to get away with it for generation after generation, and now they become the obligatory winner of the election because Hillary is close cousins to Donald. Yeah, you cannot read this in English for reputational reasons, okay? The golf club Telt Ongeveer 500 Leiden. Yeah, Leiden, right next to the place where the Pilgrim Fathers sailed. Yeah, first to Scooby in eastern England, and then down to Plymouth, and all the Portsmouth jokes. Yeah, and what have we got now? This is just pictures of the golf course, so you can see it. Just looks like any golf course anywhere in the world, and they've got the reeds and the mirrors. Okay, Ellesmere's. Yeah, and none of it you can find in English because they are totally embarrassed by it. It was 9 holes, I think, at one time. I think it'll be 18 holes now. Okay, and Pito, Reske, Dorpi, Loenen, Anvecht. Yeah, goodness knows what that is, but all of it is the use of the Pi Pi Piso biblical joke and the launch of the false religion and the Episcopalians that are now in charge of the whole of the killing of everyone of the war dead. Yeah, and the ones that are out of Verdun are particularly ironic. Yeah, and I forget where the poppies were founded. Okay, there's no point in me trying to read you that out of Flemish or whatever the language is.
Colin Montgomery is mentioned because he is the Douglases. The Montgomerys are the Dukes of Buccleuch. The major risk to the Scottish kings that are actually English kings that are actually German kings. Still.
Right then. So, next one is Floris V, Count of Holland. He's on those bloodlines with all of the great aristocrats that run the world. That is the Merovingians, that is the Capetans, that is all of the names that they say in the King's Speech film, Bertie. It's okay to call yourself Bertie, just to let them know it's us, as long as you stammer on the Windsor word. Okay? So, this is the real ancient history of that time, and it's going to take me quite a long time to show you this, if you want to see it. Okay? This is Graf Floris, yeah?
That's what he's got as his main political tool. Yeah? And he's got the Lord Lion Shield so that they can
take over everybody's land.
And if you look at the carpet, even the swastika.
Yeah, even back in those days, I'll give you his dates now so you can see how long that swastika windmill joke out of old Amsterdam has been ruling the world.
Yeah, by tyranny, 1256 to 1296. Predecessor, William II. Successor, John I. Spouse, Beatrix of Flanders. Yeah, right in the middle, yeah, of those killing places in all the great conflicts.
Okay, and the Whittingham language for the Balfours later on, which is why we've got that tab that I cannot tell you about today.
Yeah, that's the Whittingham place that was home for Arthur Balfour, who partitioned Poland right next to my sister's dwelling place. And my sister will not talk to me now because I'm too political.
Okay, and here we've got the mother of this person was Elizabeth of Brunswick-Lunenburg. Yeah, that's Hitler's new Brunswick when he comes along. Okay, Floris reigned as Count of Holland and Zealand.
Yeah, that's the New Zealand joke. Yeah, it's actually Old Zealand.
From 1256 and 1296, his life was documented in detail in Rigmon Chroniac by Melis Stoke, his chronicler. Yeah, and this will be the Stoke jokes about the Stoker jokes about the vampires and the cliffs near Scarborough. Yeah, they're ever so worried about the reputations going astray, as if they could prevent that. Okay, credited with mostly peaceful reign, modernizing admin policies beneficial to trade, generally acting in the interests of his peasants at the expense of nobility. You can see why he was at risk. His dramatic murder, engineered by King Edward de Longshanks of England and Guy, Count of Flanders. Yeah? In it, right up to their necks, and they're still in it as the Better Off Together movement, which is the Plantagenets for a laugh, and the bedroom tax. Yeah? Broom was the icon for the Plantagenets that are Longshanks. Yeah? Yeah, the rest of it is bedroom stories, and that will be boring for you if you're a golfer, but maybe not Donald. Okay, he was the son of Count William II, who was slain in 1256 by Frisians when Floris was just two. Yeah, and Floris, you get that now, that is the PISO name translated from Italian. Yeah, and it means flowers, and that is Floris Castle for Guy in his care, who's in the same set of families as the Douglases and the Flemings, yeah, and the traitors of Scotland. Yeah, and they are of Kersdale, and that is across in Ayrshire, where Donald has his golf course. Okay, and this is the Holy Roman Emperor, the Battle of Reimerswald on 22nd January 1266. 1263, featuring Count Otto II, that's Otto Piso, yeah, and his lineage, all the way through the Holy Roman Emperor joke for Germania.
Count of Gelders, which is another horsey joke. Yeah, I think that's them without their bullocks on. Geldings. Okay, Otto served as Floris V's guardian until he was 12, yeah, and he could not save him when Longshanks became his enemy. Or his children, I'm not sure which one's got topped. Okay, let's go down until, and here's the links to financial services. Okay, Holland, Penny or Kopje. The Copsy Home jokes and the links to Austria and Switzerland are now beginning to become more obvious. Can you see the Red Cross derivation? Yeah, and all of it is false Christianity. Okay, Hainaut, and this is the Hainaut car industry and the House of Avennes, who was an arch enemy of the Count of Flanders of the House of Dampierre. Yeah, that's the mirrors and the dampness, because the gods piss on them all of the time. Okay, in 1972 he was 1272 unsuccessfully attacked at the Frisians in a first attempt to retrieve the body of his father. Okay, it's a bit boring in a context of British treason. Yeah, and you can see the links of the Christian nations to stealing from all of the worshippers, yeah, and sending them all to war again and again and again. Yeah, Kenemerland, that is even the Jewish jokes. Yeah, and that is Alkmaar, Haarlem and the surroundings, Waterland, north of Amsterdam, and Amstelland, and surroundings, and the West Frisians, and the Amschel Rothschild linkage. Okay, Kenemerland was a dune land, yeah, and that's the sand dunes for the golf courses in Scotland where Donald runs his wind power Ponzi schemes. Yeah, look it up on my website, Prof. George Lee's /revelations, and look up Dunwilko, and you'll see his 3,000 wind power jokes about keeping the Rotary Club going and all of the world's fascists out of black and orange Holland, yeah, being prepared to kill all of the world's troops in all of the great conflicts everywhere. It's getting boring. Let's find another tab. Elizabeth, this is the one that means that the timelines cannot be dissected. She's of Rutland, yeah, and that's where John Paterson relatives ran the Bank of England for a while, yeah, with Paterson with one T. Countess Consort of Holland, Rutland Castle, Denbighshire. Yeah, that's England. Died 5th May 1316, and she was born in 1882, so she died aged 33. Waltham Abbey in Essex. Yeah, right next door to those fisheries where I used to fish. And there's the spouses at that time are John I, Count of Holland, and her second husband was Humphrey de Bohun. So that is not mentioned at all in those bloodlines that David Icke has produced. But I believe that he is from Henry II and not from the loins of Longshanks, and Edward II, his poofy son. Okay? And the Humphreys of Umfraville, and the Devons that are the people that own that massive castle that is Downton Abbey, yeah, and they are actually in Derby, which is Gordon Bowman's constituency, and Northampton is where Princess Diana came from, and that's where all of the death camps were, so that they could ship in political plants from other countries they were fighting against, put them in jail, and then allow them to lead the treason, yeah, from within. Yeah, and all of those death camps have the same template as the Great Escape movie. Yeah, and all of the people that are defending the death camps and have the keys to them are on the same side, and it's the same at Colditz, which is really embarrassing when you reveal the Innsbruck joke and the Brookses of the hotel chains, yeah, that were rendered insolvent 2 years ago have now sold out, because the truth is out that they were double agents like Fleming in all the great conflicts. Alistair Brooks, the Bourbon from Paris, and Gav, yeah, listed on Britain's fascist listings, yeah, and my schoolboy chum, Edward I was the father, and the mother was Eleanor of Castile.
Okay.
This is the woman that we could not find. And the bloodlines for her are totally different, and I've now found them into Cumbria and Ireland, and right across into America and into the presidential bloodlines, with the Hutchisons in the middle. Those are my neighbours in my hometown. Yet that refused to sign my petition on when my wife, who works for Chipping Norton and Cameron, the Camerons are also in the Freskin Douglas lineages. Yeah, it's the one of the biggest power-broking family groupings in the whole of Western Europe. And it's still there, and all of them still play the polo, and they're friends of King Charles. Prince Charles, yet still. Right, let's get another tab. This is the Cronenberg Castle that they have taken down, and my attempts to find it. Castle in the province Utrecht. You cannot find it in anything other than foreign languages. Because it's the fucking golf course now. Okay, there it is. So you can find it if you go in Dutch or Flemish or whatever they call it, lingo. Yeah. When you look for it in English, it does not exist, or it takes you into Scandinavia or somewhere else where you don't want to go. And it's got a monumental status, yeah, for every golf player across our land. Yeah, there's the florist, the owner, yeah. Even the night that I looked it up for the first time, it would not translate into English, and that's pretty unique, apart from the stories I've told you about Lord Kerr of Kinlochard, who's also in the Central Belt in Scotland. Yeah, and that is the flooding of the fishing lakes that I used to fish on, and Ronnie Glass is on that story, and he is the glass joke about the Douglas family. Yeah, it's amazing, and all the ancient treaties they sign into, those are their slogans. Yeah, that the Douglases will conquer. Right, so Castellan in the province. Yeah, so there's nothing on the internet at all in English about this massive castle that I thought might be on one of the islands on the golf course, but you're not allowed to know. And the golf course website is totally in Dutch, and this is the one that, oh, they've interfered with my Shakespearean tab, because when you look for this, you get Shakespeare's output. Oh no, they haven't taken it down. I'm not sure why we've got those little yellow icons on there. I've never seen that before. Okay, so this is the Loenen old golf course, and it's Cronenberg Castile, and I can't mind which of the Shakespearean plays. This page has changes that could not be merged during synchronization. Click here to show versions of the page with unmerged changes. So there is the old course in Holland that is Loenen. Yeah, and it looks beautiful and silky compared to the Loening, which is the rough on in the Kelso course. And there it is, and it looks just like Musselburgh, and Musselburgh is the oldest course in Britain, and it's one of the earliest race courses, and on the complex fascism workings go. Right then. So Castel, Wikipedia, Cronenberg, so they've not given me the information on the Shakespearean links. We could click on that and it could crash my computer, or we could, and here's the great victory for Edward Gall and Glocks Zonic Pri Saint George Cronenberg. Yeah, you can only get snippets of it, and there's the PISO horsey joke again, and the upright ears, which is Winston Churchill's icon. Okay, and so we're gonna have to click on that if we want to see the Shakespearean links. I'm too scared to do that. Let's go to the bottom of the tabs first and then we'll have a go. Okay, Loenen and De Vecht. Far more detail and windmills than on the English page. See Leiden Confessions below. Okay, so this is another early attempt to find more about the crime scene for the world's oldest golf course and the launch of the Pilgrims. There it is. Lovely looking wooded area. Yeah, do you get that joke now?
Yet the masons outside have been at it all afternoon.
Brug de Vecht, met op, yeah, still in Dutch. Yeah, and the Kirk joke, Kirk Douglas. You get it?
And his son is a continuation of that, I forget what his name was.
Yeah, Vurmelig Gementus Loenen. Nothing in English, because they're totally ashamed of it, Donald and the master race at Augusta.
Vecht Brug Loenen,
yeah. The Bailey Bridges, and there is the giants that they fight in the imagination that is the writings of the PISO pen, yeah, and all the jokes about the Rotary Club and the windmills being the sun's rays now and energy that is prepared to fuel the whole of our earth and the nuclear weapons that they then launch on their friends.
I don't think we're going to get Shakespeare unless we take the risk of viral plagues.
Yeah, it's all in Dutch, okay? And here is Longshank's daughter Lizzie
on this. So there's Henry III married Eleanor of Provence. Then we come into Longshanks and we get to the wedding, that first marriage of Elizabeth
to Fergus, Lord of Galloway. But they are about 80 years apart.
Yeah,
and she is actually courting the kids who were involved with Henry II.
Yeah, and that is the time shift.
So Longshanks died in 1308, I thought, but Edward II, the Pooty son, is married to these other lineages. And it is totally twisted. And here's all the Galloway jokes. And that one is the east coast of Scotland, that is Gunilda of Dunbar, and that is where Bishop O'Brien, yeah, the B Arian joke for the cardinal in Scotland, who never gets arrested, never gets brought to justice, never even gets taken to an asylum home like Pope Benedict.
Yeah, all of them live in elite lifestyles that is way beyond even me thinking about now. Yeah, as the world's most informed exposer of this massive genocide,
Roland Lord of Galloway. Yeah, and then we get to the De Lacys of Ulster. Yeah, and the Quincys and descendant of Henry I in France. Yeah, that is the difference, because they've got the wrong side of the bloodline by mistake.
Yeah, or as an obfuscation tool, which they often use. Okay, let's go to the next one. And it's the Dutch Hollands that are their lovers. So this is where I found it out.
Lord Utrecht, Mark Ferguson, de la Galloway. Do you get the Fergusons and all the Man United jokes and all of the propagandists for the Rothschild jokes and all of those stories I've told you about their massive mansions and their faked up European history? Okay, that is not a date, that is the registration number on the genealogical website. This is the same man who married Gunhilda. It is not the son of Elizabeth and Longshanks.
Okay, so we go down and we see that this writer is prepared to declare that.
So there's the Gunhild of Dunbar, the next generation. Oh no, it
was in highlighted. And that's Allendale in real life. Lord Fergus of Galloway, Perth, Scotland.
So Galloway is not in Dumfries in this story, it's actually in the central belt of Scotland, in Perth.
Yeah, so you believe what you like. The whole of history has been totally totally twisted, but not as nearly as some of the incumbents or claimants to the throne. This one, who lived on Loch Fergus, Galloway, Perth, Scotland. Cause of death: brutally mutilated, blinded, castrated and murdered by his brother Gilbert, Gilbrigd and Gilbricht. Occupation: Lord of Galloway and Constable of Scotland.
Law enforcement still. Okay, and where is the statement that this is?
I kind of believe that they have taken it down. That this this is not about Longshanks' relatives, it's about, I had it highlighted, but it's no longer highlighted. Utrecht. No, it's for somehow they have taken it off. Henry the First's mother. I'm really sorry, folks. It was, I posted it on Facebook the other day, and that was able to tell you the story of the fact that the people that are below Longshanks on the world owning bloodline have actually come from Henry the Second. But incredibly, they've been allowed to take that down, and I don't know how they did it. Anyway, look it up. I could click on the hyperlink, but that's going to take too much. Let's keep going. So this is the Puttioli jokes about the golf and the putter. Yeah, and you get the hole, being into the hole she goes for Dave. Dave Allen, that is the Holy Ghost joke for Dave Allen, the Irish Freemason. And all of them that are sharing those Roosevelt jokes know that Delaney's donkey for him is the war dead. Yeah, and it's Jesus in the fucking Bible. Yeah, the donkey ears joke for all of them. Yeah, and this is the PUTLocker and Osco Fistula's cave, which is exactly the same story. Yeah, exactly the same story. Translates into Italian as PISO. Yeah, the pie jokes for the American pie and for Britney Spears and all of the people in the sorority, even the women now. Yeah, well used, from the Sibels to, and the Osco Fistulus is the cave. Yeah, in the Bible stories. Okay, so how have we started on this? So there's Naples, and if you go further across in Naples, you find Pozzuoli, and that is the PUTLocker place. Yeah, and it's the Podgers and the Pozzos, yeah, for Rabsinism. And this is where the Bible was written, and it's right underneath Vesuvius, which is why the Villa Papyri was buried. Right then. And the golfing joke has been covered up systematically since I exposed it. So PUTLocker is in Naples. It's on top of the yellow ash that comes out of the sulfurous volcano. Yeah. And the Roman colony was established in 194 BC, took the name Puttioli, which it has its roots from Puttius. Yeah? And do you get the Putin jokes now about all their allies in the New World Order that are just slaves to the system so they can own the world by tyranny and deceit for all of that time? Yeah? And that is the PISO fanny. Well used, from the Sibels. Okay, that is the writings of the author, meaning well, yeah, in other words, it's in the hole, used from Sibels, yeah, well used from Sibels to predict the future, and Osco Fistula's cave. Quite crude, really, isn't it? And schoolboyish, David Cameron. The Latin patio, to stink, referring to the sulfuric smell in the area, most notably from Solfatera. This is because Pozzuoli lies in the centre of the flagrant camping films that are Carry On Camping. Yeah, and all of it is Barbara Windsor's tits flapping around in the breeze under a volcanic caldera that is Rothschild yellow. And that is the Lemons, which is the Jewish side of the story, all of it written by the same families. Main hub for goods exported from Campania, including blown glass, yeah, to be blown. I dare not speak about it because I'm
sakes. Yeah, that is the Floors joke, that Floors Castle for Guy in his care is the mosaics out at Naples. Yeah, all of it translation from lingo to lingo, and all a massive joke, even for the Roman troops 2,000 years ago. Wrought iron and marble cooks.
Right then.
And that is even the Oliphant in the Episcopalian church in Kelso. The dad still stands against the column as if he was Madonna making a sexy video.
And Madonna is now the mother of God in heaven. And you know how God feels about that, which is why they have the volcanic reactions.
Reinforced concrete domes, yeah, the replacement of the Christian vents with the murderous Moorish vents out of the mirrors, yeah, next to the golf course. Right. I don't think we've got anything highlighted further down. Oh, pew pew, do you get it? Barney McGrew, everything is a joke in every classical song, including the one, the ones by Rossini about the foot of the willow are jokes about kissing the toes and the pie piggies that are down there, or kissing the fanny as you go down on it.
Yeah, and that's why in the Lord of the Rings film, at the foot of the willow, yeah, they had to take, yeah, at the foot of the willow, which means the wood. Yeah, you get it? All of the Roman troops got it, and it was a huge joke. And it meant that all of the gods that had names before the PISO treason were deserted and laughed at in the subsequent story making. Okay, Italian, Cheech, Pew,
yeah, Pie, Pew, Pew, Barney McGrew, Cuthbert, Dibble and Grub.
Okay, every song. And so this is the Patioli joke, and I'll show you the bicycle riding stuff. Yeah, that's as low as it gets. But the big Patioli thing that I saw the last time I went here has been taken down totally off the internet. That is the Bic Pen company, typically run out of treasonous France. Okay.
Josephus landed here on his way to Rome. The life of Flavius Josephus. That is Arius Calpurnius Piso,
the man on that golf course for Donald all around the world now,
but leading the Pilgrim Fathers out of Leiden. Yet, do you get the lying den joke for the birth of Jesus? Yeah, and the usual suspects in the launch of the new stories.
For the emirs,
it is Ben Yusuf.
Right then. Sophia Loren, film actress, grew up here.
Yeah, did not know that until that is the lover of El Cid in the film. Totally traitor to him, yeah, because he killed his dad for the name of the family and the reputation of the family. This is Billy Connolly's joke. St. Proculus was affectionately nicknamed U Pi Pi Pisciata Soto, yeah, son of Otto from the Piso family, and the Pisci is the fish, which is the penis that goes in the fanny and into the pie for Britney Spears. And Don McLean, the pants pisser, that is not me what has written that. Okay, do you get it? This is the Proculus that they use up your bum to see whether or not you have got cancer in the willy.
Yeah, and November the 16th we've just passed, and it was a beautiful blue sunlit day for the whole of the day here, and it's often the day of rain.
Yeah, because every saint in our world never existed. All of them are just a joke like that.
And in the place that is Douglas, near Lanarkshire, it is St. Bride's, and that is the same church joke that Rupert Murdoch used to get married to his third wife at St. Bride's in London, with all of the Do They Know It's Christmas jokers in attendance, because all of them know that Jesus never was there at Christmas, like the Monty Python's team.
Right then, I think I'm going to stop when I get down to the bottom of these tabs, and it's a we might have a little adventure with that Shakespeare story. Prince Philip was born on the island of Capri. I knew that, but I did not know where the island of Capri is. It's there, right off the coast of with Vesuvius on it. Yeah, do you get the linkages now? This is one of the world's most evil men, has taken away the sovereignty of Britain's great nation, yet has led us into poverty and all of the banking scandals. He's sold the Bank of England again to the people that keep it in private hands, and that's Mark Carney, the Carnival joke out of Austria. Yeah, do you get it? Prince Philip was born there. Yeah, and there's the Sorrento cafe owners that used to live in the same hometown as me, maybe because they learned that the golf course there was to become a legend in world history. Okay, so, shall we take a risk? What's the last tab? Sully, oh, to be sullied. Womanizer, Valeria. Okay, let's have a quick look. And what is Valerian illness again? Can't remember. Yeah, the blue bloods will remember it well. Yeah. And every time I engaged in slightly deviant sexuality, all of my fluid from the mouth, it was Rothschild yellow because of my choice of partner, and all of it is given us by God, and very few of us realize it. Yeah, until you're backed into the corner that they've put me in. I don't know what this one's going to be about. To be sullied. Lucius Cornelius Sulla. He's been punched in the nose. And he is the dictator of the Roman Republic. Gaius, or he's a PISO too. Servilius Geminus. Yeah, Gaius Julius Caesar in 49 BC. Okay, this is the real Julius Caesar with the same initials as the Son of God that you might have heard about before. Yeah, and there's the Gnaeus Pompeius. Yeah, that is the Pompeii place under Vesuvius where many of them lived. And I'm not sure why we put this up. I've not got any written info on it. But he had the distinction of holding the office of consul twice and reviving the dictatorship, so he's sullying the good name of Rome given it by the Pisos. Yet I've not got anything on him. Sully, 79 BC, that's 79 BC when Vesuvius, no, that's 79 AD was when Vesuvius erupted. This was when the Pisos were running the mints in Rome. Right, let's take a chance on crashing our computer, yeah, and getting into the bunker, yeah, in Leiden, that is, yeah, the bunker for Hitler, yeah, and all the little blue dress jokes. So we're at this page's changes that could be not be merged during synchronization to Shakespeare and all of our false news, yeah, out of Stratford-on-Avon. So I've now clicked on it. Click here to show versions of the page with unmerged changes. Click here to hide versions of the page. So I've clicked, it does not look as if anything has happened. And there will be no Shakespearean information on there, I don't think. No. So the Shakespearean link, my Shakespearean knowledge is ever so poor because I'm a Scotsman and none of it ever made sense to me. But I don't know what. So there's the old course logo, and I think we'll just sign off on that. I'll try and find out about the Shakespearean link and post it in the thumbnail. Do you get it? The Loenen is the rough in my hometown between the golf course, and runs right through the middle of the golf course, and he's right in front of the racecourse. Yeah, and you've seen all the PUTLocker jokes and the big PUTLocker jokes. Don't know where that is, because it's become a bicycle ad. Yeah, and that is the PISO rhyme, yeah, with the vagina and the cock and all of the denial of Jesus on, yeah, those days where he's getting on the cross, and St. Andrew's cross at St. Andrew's golf course in America, in Britain, it is that same icon as the cross keys for the first church in the world that was bigger than the Vatican. The Vatican was only built in the late 19th century. Yeah, do you get it? The cross keys for the biggest church in the world is the joke about the Cluny Abbey in Clermont-Saint-Ferrand, where the first killing took place in World War I. Yeah, and this is Verdun. Yeah, it is absolutely ruthless. And if you look at the other golf courses in America, they are all, the world's most ancient golf courses in America are all in that. Oh, we've got a whole host of other tabs. Sorry. Okay, so St. Proculus. So here's a translate tab. Translate to the fight. Okay, what does Loenen mean? This is what Loenen means, yeah? Love your neighbour. Loenen means let's take us to the fight against the pagan Indians in America. Poor things, they are America's native sons. Good morning, America, how are you? Yeah, I'm your native son, says the white man. Right then. Here's the big patioli joke. It's now the ride on the bike. And it is Bournemouth International Centre. Yeah, when you look up Bic Patioli in the old days, it was Naples, and it was the pen that created the Bible. They've been very quick to change that. Okay, and that's. And if it had been BIS, it's the Bank of International Settlements, and it's now become the Department of Business, Innovation and Skills. They're ever so quakey. Yeah, like all of the places around them. Yeah? And that's Bournemouth International Centre, and that is Bournemouth on the south coast, right next to Plymouth and Portsmouth, where all the treason occurs on the Isle of Wight. Yeah, and all of the jokes about the massive horsey people that are the Earl Marshals of our country, who run the shareholding scams out of selling shares in religion in the cathedral at Arundel. You may notice that Bay Naples is Buck Patioli. That is taken from my last article on this. Yeah, now when you look up Buck Patioli, you get this, Buck Patioli. You get a company, and it is a bike company. Okay, and that is the reason that there's the big pens. Yeah, that's the joke about writing the Bible and the place name in Naples that I was able to expose in those earlier videos. Now completely removed. It's run by French people. Yeah, and the Guevaras that are the revolutionaries in Latin America. There it is, the Bible joke. Yeah. Bic Patioli in conjunction with the golf joke in the same town. Yeah, into the Holy Ghost. Yeah, for Dave Allen. Okay, so where are the bikes? So that's now become a money stream out of bicycles and cigarette lighters produced by Gillette, also the elite families. Chairman of the board of October was Mario Guevara. Alan Prost led the places the Formula One teams. Bic also sponsored the Alain Prost. Tate led the Prost Grand Prix team in Formula One from 1997 to 2000. The logo, two parts, a rhomboid with curved corners, right and left side angled upward, and containing the letters BIC, with J the only one in lowercase. I in the only one in lowercase. Oh, it's the Jesus joke in that instance. Do you see it? Yeah. So the colours were eventually changed to orange pant. That is the Pantheris joke. That is the pink panther. That is the pants joke for Woody, who was commentating on the Scotland versus fascist Argentina joke yesterday on the rugby pitch at David Murray's field, and the Murray jokes that I told you about in all of those stories about the Douglas being a threat, the Douglas lineages being a threat to the throne. All of them are prepared to be on the take at the citizens' expense. The ball is the tungsten carbide, one that was the key feature in Bic's new ballpoint pens. Okay, that is pens and pencils and the faking of the Bible. Golf in Italy.
The first course there is here, and it's in frenzy with a volcano over it, I think.
And there they are in their golfing gear in Italy. Oh, it's Florence. Yeah, you remember her in just before the news in the 1960s? Brought golf to Italy in 1889, 1 year after we were down the river of blood in Khartoum, despoiling everything in those primitive poor countries that Obama came from, and he's now behaving better than any world leader in world history. Home History Club, our course. Inga's board server member sit alien. Yeah, I don't know where it is. It's Florence, okay?
And I think we can now just go. I don't think anything has happened to that tab on Shakespeare.
And there is an ancient monument on Woodall Spa, Hutchin. This is the Musselburgh Old Course. Yeah, and it's exactly the same layout. There's the race course behind it. Don't know whether or not they have a Loenen. Yeah, but you can see there's a line of trees and hedges. Yeah, I would be prepared to bet that every golf course that is made as new attempts until this video is made to create a Loenen.